Welcome to Fayette County High School, home of your 2023 Fayette County Tigers. My name is Tim Miller, social studies teacher at Fayette County High School. Honored to have been selected as your master of ceremonies for tonight's graduation ceremony. Before we begin tonight's ceremony, as we celebrate this Memorial Day weekend, we would like to take this time to honor all the brave men and women who served our country. If you are a veteran, we ask that you please stand at this time. It is my distinct pleasure to welcome you here this evening for the commencement exercises for Fayette County High School Class of 2023. As the name implies, tonight is not an ending, but a beginning. The commencement of the next step in the lives of the young people whom we honor on this occasion. Since this is a dignified ceremony, we respectfully ask your cooperation in honoring the entire class of 2023. They deserve an event worthy of the admirable accomplishment that they have achieved. Please refrain from extraneous noise, celebrations, so that we may praise the hard work and dedication of all of our 2023 graduates. We also like to ask that you refrain from entering the field before and during tonight's ceremony. Your cooperation is greatly appreciated. At this time, please stand for our national anthem, performed by Fayette County's very own award-winning band, led by our own Dr. Myra Roden. Please remain standing and welcome the Fayette County High School faculty, our junior marshals, and the soon-to-be graduates of Fayette County High School, class of 2023.
Starting in Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. You may be seated. On behalf of Principal Miss Yolanda Briggs Johnson, Assistant Principals Miss Andrea Cherry Lee, Mr. Jonathan Hall, Mr. Chris Key, and Mr. Bill Stikes, and the faculty and staff of Fayette County High School, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you to the 98th Annual Commencement Exercises at Fayette County High School. 98 years. That's a long time. School opened in 1925. That was Coach Flynn's first year teaching here. To our graduates, class of 2023, congratulations. Tonight marks the culmination of many hours, days, and years of hard work where all of your efforts finally pay off. As a graduate of Fayette County High School, we applaud you, the class of 2023, for your resilience and hard work. This class has accumulated over $3 million in scholarships. Please note that we have had several updates since the time of the printing of tonight's program, and we thank you for your understanding. This evening, you join the ranks of thousands of Fayette County High School alumni who proudly regard their Fayette County education as a vital part of what makes them successful men and women that they are today. If you are a previous graduate at Fayette County High School, will you please stand so that our current graduates can see the ranks in which they will join tonight? Thank you and welcome home. Once again, congratulations, class of 2023. You've made it through 12 years of compulsory education with its coerced early morning hours of learning, eating FDA-approved tasteless food, no afternoon naps, mass public transportation to take you back home. How the good old days at Fayette County High School. But seriously, you're the pandemic generation that endured the worst years in public education history. You're the COVID kids who were trapped at home for nearly 2 years attempting to learn through the advanced technology called Zoom. This informal, impersonal platform placed on the same device that most students play games and interact on social media was doomed to fail because education will never compete for a child's attention against mind-numbing fun. If the pandemic and COVID had any positive impact, it's the realization that real learning and education comes from face-to-face teaching, in-class interactions. These interactions foster greater understanding of subjects and prompt question-answer sessions along the Socratic learning method. As a student many years ago, not 1925 years ago, during the days of chalkboards, corporal punishment, greasy hamburger, French fry, lunch bags, you know, the 80s. I don't remember too many specific things about each and every class that I took. What I do remember were the teachers, the ones who were kind and cared about me as a person, not a data point in a presentation. They showed an interest in me. Education was much more helping people, young people, and guide them into becoming productive, successful citizens in an ever-evolving world. Interactions with kind, caring educators have a far greater lasting impact than a one-time test score that months from now no one will remember. But relationships with compassionate teachers who truly care about your future is everlasting. One of the biggest reasons I stayed at Fayette County High School for 22 of my 31 years of teaching is because that's what you have here at Fayette County High School. You have some of the most caring, compassionate, kind teachers in your classrooms. Today, you exit Fayette County for the next chapter of your life. Speaking for the faculty, we wish you great success, happiness in your transition into adulthood, and hope in some small way we help make your journey a lot easier. At this time, I would like to introduce the individuals present on today's stage for tonight's ceremony. First individual on the stage is our principal, Fayette County High School, Miss Yolanda Briggs Johnson. Next, we have our Fayette County attendance clerk, Miss Angelia Hines. I'll wait a little longer. Who will be taking part in the ceremony later this evening, representing the Fayette County School System Superintendent's Office, Fayette County Public Schools Superintendent, Dr. Jonathan Patterson. And finally, representing the Fayette County Board of Education, school board member, Dr. Regina Derry. Each of these individuals will take part later in the ceremony and the presentation of senior awards and in the distribution of diplomas to the class of 2023. At this time, I would like to invite Umu So, Vice President of the class of 2023, to the podium for a special reading.
Good evening, friends, family, and the graduating class of 2023. I am Umu So, and as the class vice president, I have the honor of speaking with you all today. Over the last 4 years at Fayette County High School, we have accomplished many things and shared many experiences that led us all to graduating day. With the new chapter in our lives opening, it can be a scary and bittersweet moment to end the memories that we created on Tiger Trail. With our futures and careers just beginning, I would like to leave you all with this expert that speaks volume about never giving up. Rise Up by Tracy Golden. Embrace your beauty, your strength, and most importantly, your flaws. Be courageous when faced with adversity and smile when you have conquered the impossible. Rise up to your fears and shortcomings and face them with the belief that you are not alone and you will never be. There is so much turmoil in the world today. Be that small ripple in the water that becomes a huge wave of hope and positive change. Be that spark that ignites into a blaze of restoration. Rise up to the responsibility of reminding our youth that they are royalty and should conduct themselves as such, with the dignity and respect which is needed to be a part of our resolution and not as part of our demise. Although life often has a way to break us down, we must rise up to the realities of our destiny. We cannot be broken. We must be inspired every day to simply and deliberately rise up. I am so proud of each and every one of you sitting before me today. Good luck with all your future endeavors as we open up a new chapter in our lives. Our adventure has just begun and our race is partly finished. Let life be filled with many blessings and opportunities for us to change the world. Again, congratulations to the class of 2023.
Thank you, Umu. Next in our program, we will hear from the top two graduates of the class of 2023, our salutatorian and our valedictorian. These two students have not only achieved academic success while at Fayette County High School, they have also achieved academic perfection. Each has a few words of wisdom for the classmates as they depart the hallowed halls of Fayette County High School. The salutatorian of the class of 2023 is Iman Sharif. Iman is the daughter of Khalid and Uzma Sharif, She has excelled both in and out of the classroom. She is a four-year computer science pathway student. She is president of the National Honor Society, president of the Science National Honor Society, vice president of the Social Studies Honor Society. She is also a member of the Spanish Honor Society Beta Club academic team. In addition to her rigorous course load, Iman was part of the junior varsity and varsity lacrosse team from her freshman through junior years. She also had the opportunity to intern with Metro Atlanta Regional Commission, also known as MARC, her junior year, earning a 4.356 GPA. While taking 13 AP classes, that's pretty good. It gives me great pleasure to introduce the salutatorian for the class of 2023, Iman Sharif.
Good evening, fellow graduates, esteemed faculty, and proud parents, and distinguished guests. It's an honor to stand before you today, not only because my poor attendance did not, in fact, catch up to me, but because I can stand before you as the salutatorian of our graduating class. My name is Iman Sharif, not to be confused with Samiha, our valedictorian. If you couldn't tell, we get confused a lot. I'd like to warmly welcome everyone in attendance and express my gratitude for being part of this memorable occasion. It was August of 2019, the first day of freshman year. I was a delusional 14-year-old, filled with beliefs that high school would instantly transform me into this pretty, smart, and cool person. But reality hit hard as I entered those big doors, overwhelming me with anxiety. A suffocating feeling grew after each class until it peaked in seventh period, my programming class. Although I had randomly chosen computer science as my pathway in eighth grade, I later came to regret it. When I walked into that bleak classroom, I knew I made a mistake. Everyone in there looked like they knew what they were doing, and I was the only one who was completely lost. Determined to be successful, I pushed myself beyond my limits. After 3 years worth of hard work, my last semester of high school finally arrived. Everything fell into place. I got into my dream school, and I even managed to land a spot as a salutatorian. I felt ecstatic. However, doubt crept in, questioning whether I truly deserved or had worked hard enough for that position. That familiar suffocating anxiety resurfaced. It was then that my very sarcastic yet caring art teacher and lacrosse coach, Mr. Angelo, delivered another one of his infamous lectures. He said, "Success is a matter of perspective. Whether you think you can or you think you can't, you're right." Reflecting on buried memories, I recalled the wonderful people around me, my teachers, friends, and family. I thought about the class I dreaded the most during freshman year, seventh period. Surprisingly, I somehow stayed in Mr. Kramnik's class all 4 years of high school, and it grew on me. Although my programming skills are subpar and I still have no idea what I'm doing, I surprisingly find joy in that classroom, except when faced with those torturous projects that make me want to scream, cry, and tear my hair out. Besides Mr. Kramlich, I also remembered my other wonderful teachers who have shaped me into the person that I am today. Ms. Rabin, who shares my love of McDonald's Filet-O-Fish. Mr. Bellwood, who let me touch his bald head for good luck. Miss Elliott, who I have the best gossip sessions with. Miss Manning, who trained me to be a better student with her endless packets and textbook readings. And Miss Cook, who helped me edit my last minute college essay. You're a real one for that. From desperately eating ketchup sandwiches at lunch to forcing Mr. Bellwood to eat crunchy and expired TJ Maxx gummies during fourth period, my friends and I have shared a spectrum of unforgettable emotions and memories. I am truly grateful to you and all, and especially toward the town folk and their endless hussy mazak that will always make me laugh. Lastly, my family, you're a chaotic bunch. One moment urging me to study hard, the next, mama screaming on the phone to a tailor in Pakistan, Baba watching Vampire Diaries on full volume, Rebecca barging into my room to make yet another unfunny joke, Vanya pressuring me to do SAT prep, despite the fact that I've already been accepted into college, And finally, Daniel showing me another picture of an animal and saying, "That's you."
Oh.
All while I tried to study. But you redeemed yourself in unexpected ways. Although disguised with the usual sibling banter, my siblings watched out for me and gave me valuable advice. They went out of their way to ensure that I grew up right, even if their parenting methods were a bit off. In the dead of night, Mama prayed for me when I mentioned a stressful test. She knew me better than I knew myself, sensing my troubles without a word. She was my pillar of support, providing comfort. Baba treated me like his number one, going above and beyond to provide everything I needed, even if it stretched his budget. He would be the first one there when I called or if I needed help. Most importantly, he always said he'd be proud of me, no matter what. This shifted my perspective on success. I realized that success is not defined by titles or grades, but by happiness. For the first time in a while, I found true happiness, thanks to the unwavering support of these wonderful individuals, those who have come to cheer me on today, and my wonderful relatives all over the world, especially those in Pakistan. Thank you.
I wasn't done yet.
I share this story to emphasize that standing on this field is proof of your hard work, the support of your loved ones, and most importantly, your success. Even when times got tough, even when we wanted to give up, we pushed through. Graduates, as cliche as it may sound, we made it. Congratulations to the Fayette County High School class of 2023.
Thank you, Iman. The valedictorian of the class of 2023 is Samiha Lalani, daughter of Shaman and Nadir Lalani. She has excelled both in and out of the classroom. She's been a part of HOSA, Green Club, Beta Club, National Honor Society, Spanish Honor Society, and other organizations. She has also taken leadership roles such as vice president of HOSA, co-captain of the academic team, reporter of NHS. In addition to a rigorous course load, she's played varsity tennis all 4 years. Outside of the classroom, she's volunteered at religious institution as a team lead for the past 4 years and at Piedmont Hospital for 2 summers, earning a 4.4 GPA. While taking 13 AP classes, multiple honor classes, it gives me great pleasure to introduce the valedictorian for the class of 2023, Miss Samiha Lalani.
Good evening, my fellow graduates, the class of 2023. Just to be clear, that was Iman, our beloved salutatorian, and now it's Samiha. Today stands as proof of the resilience and dedication that each of us has displayed since entering the halls 4 years ago. All of us have dreamed of this day to come sooner than later. But now that it's here, I honestly can't believe it's real. We entered as awkward freshmen, and all of us, well, most of us, are leaving with a glow up. Our heads are held in pride for what we have accomplished, and it's all thanks to us, our skills, and our gifts. Yet, we couldn't have done it without a group of supporters behind us. The list of who I could thank would keep us here till next Wednesday, but I know long-awaited vacations or multiple grad parties are scheduled, so I will keep it brief. First, I want to thank my parents who decided to come to this country more than 20 years ago so their daughters wouldn't have to live the same life they did. Their tenacity, love, and integrity have always inspired me to work beyond the horizon. Even simple quotes such as "use your imagination," said jokingly by my father, carry a profound meaning that ignited my potential. So Mom, Dad, I hope I made you proud, and I hope to continue to do so. The teachers, all from kindergarten to 12th grade, played an immense role in becoming who I am today. Each of them has gifted me with a different strength that will carry me to success. And there are no words to encase how thankful I am. However, a couple of them deserve a shout out. Thank you, Ms. Rabin, for letting your students' creativity fly and giving them a passion to explore literature beyond writing. To Ms. Manning, for preparing us in the long run rather than just teaching us about the Silk Road. To Mr. Bellwood, who stashed our year-round gummies and, of course, taught us how to dermatize milk. To Ms. Smith, who continued to expand on my love of healthcare and provided fond, wholesome memories. To Coach Flynn, who taught me to be mentally tough while never getting over the fact that I can drive. And lastly, thanks to all my friends, extended family, and staff who all contributed and supported me during this time. Many of you played a role, big and small, but all of them deserve gratitude since I can stand here as a leader and with confidence. Throughout the years, each of us have created unforgettable memories in high school. Whether they include walking around the gym, being terrorized in Minecraft by Mr. Kramlich, conducting serious tea parties in AP literature, or going on after-school bonchon runs, there are the small things that allowed us to have a smile and laugh when times became tough. In other moments, we have seen questionable movies in the classroom, participated begrudgingly in school spirit, scrolled through horribly relating TikToks, and of course, spent the day changing classes. All of these memories, imperfect and flawless, obscure and specific, are what make our experience special and like no other. So continue to make these memories even after high school, and know that life is too short to go on without laughter. Whether you have a set plan or are still trying to explore what you love, everything will turn out for the better. This part of your life does not define you permanently. You have more than 80% left to create the name you want to be remembered by. However, we all have learned that failure will be inevitable, no matter how high you climb to the top. But view failures as an opportunity to make a difference in your lives and your communities. If Michael Jordan focused on his 300 losses, he wouldn't be one of the best basketball players in the world or be able to inspire kids. Steve Jobs and Mark Zuckerberg both dropped out of college, but they both created Facebook and Apple, which impacted the world. Beyonce faced difficulties and experienced financial pressure, but she followed her dreams to become the Queen Bee. The point is, these people who are like us never let failure define them. They saw failure as part of the journey to success, and we can too. In fact, we already have. That one failed math test or rushed essay didn't stop us from graduating today. We saw those challenges as a way to motivate us. So if you're daring to try something new and are afraid, just remember that if you have never failed, you have never lived. And I know we are all eager to walk that stage. So I want to end by saying we are always continuously looking for success. But I see it right here in the crowd at the Fayette County High School. I see it in the aspiring musicians, dedicated athletes, and the future workforce. We don't have to look far for inspiration because it's there by being true to our values. When you leave here today, celebrate the success of this incredible milestone in your life and hold on to the memories and experiences that have shaped you. Embrace your future by continuing this legacy of greatness. Once again, congratulations, class of 2023. May our futures be as bright as the stars that will shine above us tonight. Thank you.
Thank you, Sambiha and Ian. You have both represented Fayette County High School very well. I know we will see great things from you in the future. We look forward to celebrating your post-secondary accomplishments with you in the coming years. At this time, I would like to invite to the podium our Fayette County High School principal, Ms. Yolanda Briggs Johnson, and later our other dignitaries on the stage who will present several special awards to members of the graduating class of 2023.
At this time, we We are honored to present two very special awards to members of the class of 2023, voted on by the faculty, staff, and administration at Fayette County High School. These awards embody the school's mission, which is excellence in all we do. Although we have many outstanding seniors in the class of 2023, we would like to recognize these students for their exceptional scholarship, leadership, citizenship, and civic responsibility. The first award that I will present is the Principal's Award. The Principal's Award is selected by the administration to recognize a student who exemplifies Tiger Pride. The recipient of this award should exhibit exceptional character, an amiable personality, and a strong commitment to his or her school, as evidenced by extracurricular participation and support of the various programs at Fayette County High School. This year's recipient has been a leader of our school in and out of the classroom. As a member of HOSA and the Black Student Union, this student boasts a weighted GPA of 4.02. This young lady has been accepted into and will be attending Kennesaw State University. Fayette County High School's English teacher, Dr. Brian Harmon, remarks, "She is one of a kind." There are not many young ladies who can wear their academic, cultural, and spiritual identities on their sleeve and still be one of the coolest, most popular students in the school. She is mature beyond her years and makes the business of being a scholar look easy. As a BSU officer, her assistance in managing study skills underclassmen made her invaluable to my class. I am glad she is finally being recognized for her hard work and dedication. As principal of the Fayette County High School, I am proud to present the 2023 Principal's Award to Umu So.
I'm gonna try later, okay?
At this time, I would like to invite to the podium Fayette County Public Schools Superintendent, Dr. Jonathan Patterson, who will present the Superintendent's Award.
The Superintendent's Award is presented annually to a member of this senior class. The winner is a student exhibiting spirit, enthusiasm, school pride, stellar academics, and is an overall school leader. This year's recipient truly exemplifies all of these characteristics. This student has held the title of principal bassist of the Fayette County High School Symphonia and Chamber Orchestra. Fayette County High School orchestra teacher Dr. Batul's Soykin remarks, "This student carries her artistry with a gracious poise and dignity. Her modesty is noteworthy. She is a leader and a mentor to her orchestra classmates for the last 2 years. I have no doubt she will continue to inspire the future generation." Last year, this student represented the Fayette County High School nationally and internationally. She toured with the National Youth Orchestra throughout Europe and took part in the Music for Future talk show during the prestigious Lucerne Festival in Switzerland. On behalf of the Fayette County Orchestras, we are beyond proud of this young lady, and we are looking forward to her career in classical music. We all wish her Godspeed. In the fall, this student will be taking her talents to Juilliard. This year's Superintendent Award is presented to Miss Bria Reeves.
Thank you.
Thank you, distinguished guests. The Latin term alma mater is literally translated nourishing mother and refers to the intellectual nourishment that a school provides its students. This sentiment is often captured in song and presented at events such as graduation, and no one ever knows the words. This sentiment is... At this time, please stand while the Fayette County Band and Mackenzie Hubert, Sr. lead us in singing the alma mater, Fayette County High School. You'll find the words printed in the back of your graduation program. Miss Mackenzie Hubert. That was actually pretty good for not really knowing the lyrics to that one. The moment has finally arrived, the moment when Fayette County High School students become Fayette County High School graduates. At this time, I would like to ask Fayette County High School Principal Ms. Jolanda Reeves Johnson, as well as our distinguished guests, to step forward to present the diplomas to the graduating seniors. Fayette County High School class of 2023. Reading the graduate names this evening is Fayette County High School's very own Miss Angelia Hines.
To Dr. Jonathan Patterson, the superintendent of Fayette County High School System, and to Fayette County Board of Education, as the principal of the Fayette County High School, I certify that these students have met all requirements set forth by the State Board of Education and Fayette County Board of Education and are hereby eligible for their particular high school diploma or certificate. On behalf of the Fayette County faculty and staff, I would like to extend my heartfelt congratulations to the class of 2023. We wish you the utmost success in your future and always exemplify excellence in all we do with tiger pride. Parents, friends, and relatives, I proudly present the class of 2023.
Samiha Nadia Shah Lalani. Iman Khalid Sharif. Joshua Jordan Achu. Goodness Aruba Modupe Adelaide. Elise Joelle Bennett. Sanaya Saifala Bomani. Jack Michael Brady. Sydney Melinda Brown. Manuel Gustavo Canias Mejia. Brian Arnolfo Colocho Valle. Kyla Madison Dorsey. Ana Renee Love Igaro. Mackenzie Amaya Floyd. Denaya Simone Foster. Alexander Christopher Gabriel. Shifa Shafiq Galani. Lanaya Jasmine Gathers. Kyla Joanne Godfrey. Samaya Alexandria Googe. Julian Bryce Hall. Megan Milan Hall. Adriana Paige Hamilton. Akira Demoris Harden. Ryan Lee Harvey. Jolan Kenyon Hazel. Kaden Kwan Lin Hong. Olawatobi Davidson Ijawaye. Marquise Emmanuel Jones. Sitara Layla Juma. Octavia Nicole Cahan. Nicholas James Matthias Kinner. Zara Khan. Taylor Gabrielle Kimball. Raquel Diane Lachey Law. Aubrey Madison Lewis. Z Heng Lin. Kennedy Lynn Mobley. Jordan Sinead Montgomery. Arrington Omari Rashad Moore. Demaya Angelina Moore. Kyrese Keenan Mosby. Jayla Yema Musa. Vishal Nag Chowdhury. Lene Deanne Nelson. Jaden Allen Nawalo. Kayla V. Wynn. Kyla Simone Ohande. Osasawan Grace Omamude. Annabelle Yameli Orozco. Daniel Chase Ortiz. Sierra Diamond Osai. Mia Corinne Palmer. Justin Christopher Pruitt. Vanna Maibong Quach. Jada Vavleen Quarles. Michelle Lee Rattery. Jasmine Virginia Ray. Ziandre Martel Richard. Bria Michelle Reeves. Raul Rodriguez Jr. Muhammad Hanan Sajid. Marissa Ariana Santiago. Umu Fatima So. Giselle Alexia Sutherland. Janaya Thomas. Sabrina Ashland Tingle. Samantha Ireland Tingle. Brody Allen Toe. Noah Anthony Warney. Brianna Kate Wheeler. Samantha Navella Williams. Shekinah Cadre Williams. Chloe Dominique Wilson. Christopher Warren Bush. Michael Lamar Cook. Kyle Daniel Cleveland. Sebastian Nelson Dorga. Adrian Elizabeth Forrester. Dominique Nicole Doms. Eva Marie Moore. Aswani Adan. Melanie Nicole Ramos. Tamuwani Elo Ejiboye. Frederica Elizabeth Alexis. Juan Felipe Amasquita Acosta. Jalen Alexander Anderson. Jonah Aaron Anderson. Janaya Anthony. Nova Camille Arnold. Zoe Michaela Barclay. Tanaya Javier Baugh. Sydney Helena Beaton. Deviante Martez Bland. Hezekiah Benoit Bowser. Colin Robert Boylan. Navea Tennis Bradley. Cordarius Antonio Brewer. Alea Talon Bridges. Jordan DeJohn Burnside. Mark Anthony Caldwell II. Kenneth Maximus Calloway Jr. Justin James Campbell. Wasano Kirk Campbell. Aiden Christopher Karstoffen. Sydney Monroe Carter. Talia Antonia Cintron. Jarrell Trevon Clavo Jr. Marcus Atrell Collins. Linda Janice Colmore. Armonte L.B. Eddie Copeland. Hallie Elise Crane. William Abram Crane. Chelsea Alani Cranes. Anaya Kisei Crowell. Saeed Mateen Cubitt. Peyton Deshaun Dalton. Jalimar Davila Rivera. Jacaria Andrell Davis. Macy Nicole Davis. Paige Cannell Davis Hudson. Xavier Beyond Dawson. Stanley Delorme Tronfell. Michaela Ayana Lila Valpesh Willock. Elijah Jabbar DeSoto. Arnell Dickens. Nicole Dong. Darian Caban Drake. Chad Rondell Duncan. Jamonte Rennell Dunn. Ari Rachel Dunson. Nathaniel Lamont Kamarion Ely. Ramaya Sade Irby. Malik Nasir Muhammad L. Muhammad Zain Elahi. Naima Elaine Elliott. Beyonce Betsada Espinal. Daniel Espinal. Anton Jakai Felton. Michael Mario Fernandez Torres. John Alexander Harold Fleming. Denise Danae Fleming. Chance Nasir Fondley. Isaiah Joseph Franklin. Axel Nemeus Phineas. Galen Miles Futrell. Kevin Gallego Ceres. Brian David Gallegos Arrieta. Isaiah Garrett. Vivica Elise Gerhart. Stephen Andrew Generally Jr. Sarai Christian Glasgow. Nathaniel Herbert Paul Graham. Christian Emmanuel Grant. Janazia Abria Greer. Todd Jason Gresham. Sienna Danielle Guillaume. Jalen Omari Tyrone Gully. Paige Jasmine Sandra Hall. Malachi Shamir Hambrick. Jalea Sanai Harmon. Mackenzie Ray Harper. Xavier Logan Harris. Ayana Joelle Haskins. Dylan Tyler Hawkins. Michael Tyrone Hawkins. Isaiah O'Brien Heath. Abigail Amari Herod. Trenton Lee Hill. Davis Eric Hoffman. Miles Jermaine Howard. Mackenzie Taya Hubert. McQuaylen Jannard Hurst. Robert Deshaun Hurst. Christopher Eros Arrieta Katota. Anthony Micah Jacobs. Ariel Grace Johnson. Austin Levi Jones. Jaden Kennedy Brooke Jones. Justin Brett Jones. Miracle D'Angelo Jones. Anthony Amari Jordan. Michael Stephen Kennedy. Reginald Clement Kennedy Jr. Kazar Ali Khan. Tyler Peyton Kyle. Cameron Alonzo Kilpatrick. Marie Kilpatrick. Cassius Ahmad Kiner. Jelani Romel Kingston. Isaiah Paul Andrew Kong. Sanaya Malia Langston. Kevin Van The Lee. Jeremiah Pratt Lowry. Joshua Devon Mack. Giovanna Marrero. Madison Sky Mask. Joseph Anthony Mask. Markel Lamont Stewart Maupin. Alyssa Nicole McCoy. Tierney Marquise McCoy. Adonis DeKeese McGraw. Zachary Armand McCoy. Natalie Denise Mingo. Asaya Kimari Mitchell Varner. Maurice Anthony Mobley III. Joshua Leon Rogers Montgomery. Brandon Edward Moore. Tyler Cruz Moore. Alex Christian Newsom Harris. Cecilia Ta Nguyen. Minkang Phu Nguyen. Tatum Nicole Sierra. Neil. Okay. Paris St. Pete Daniel Morris Jr. Justice Maxwell Northern. Angel Ogene Rede Kachika Ogodo. Justin Curtis Orechisi Okonkwo. April Ortega. Danye Marie Peacock. Brandon Marquise Perez. Nevea Lisa Perez. Sanaya Janae Perry. Corey Anderson Bradley Pivot. Abril Pontaprino. Kira Ariana Powell. Elena Jade Presley. Mac Shiler McKenna Presley. Jaylee Jamira Raglan. Joshua Nasir Ray. Zion Lee Reeder. Faith Elizabeth Richards. Logan Hosea Richards. Janaya Kiera Nicole Robinson. Alexis Marie Rodriguez. Naomi Jose Rodriguez Terran. Jair Rodriguez Chavez. Christopher Ryan Rogers. Tatiana Diamond Rosario. Catherine Elise Ross. Ethan Zachary Rowland. Jayla Nicole Sagos. Samad Samnani. Alicia Patricia Samuel. August Kayla Latrice Scott. Jalen Alexander Seymour. Akil Edward Shackleton. Aaron Gilbert Shackleton. Alexander Lawson Shira. Brianna Yvette Simpson. Peyton Brielle Strakovich. Brian John Strickland. Kyra Renee Tanner. Travis Micah Taylor. Ruby Tapa. Alexander Brian Thompson. Daquan Narik Timmons. Ricky Marquel Valenzuela. Jada Rayanne Vaughn. Omar Juan. Seth Isaac Wash. Brittany Ariana Wheeler. Michaela Davina White. Avery Kaden Christine Wilkinson. Anaya Williams. Cameron Williams. Jeremiah Isaiah Williams. Kennedy Deja Alicia Williams. Najee Deshaun Harrison Williams. Jason Yang, congratulations.
Congratulations, graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, can we please have another round for your graduates, class of 2023. Thank you. At this time, the president of the class of 2023, Jayla Musa, will lead our graduates in the time-honored traditions of changing the class rings and the tassel. She will also introduce the class song of 2023, Jayla Musa.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Jayla Musa, and I am the president of the graduating class of 2023. I have been granted the honor of conducting this class in the academic tradition of turning the tassels. But first, let me leave you with some parting words.
I've thought about what to say at graduation since the beginning of the school year. Every time graduation got brought up in class, someone would tell me, please don't make this speech long, or make sure it's not boring, Jayla. I will try my best to do that for y'all. First, I'd like to congratulate everyone in front of me. We made it. No matter how long it took or how many hardships we came across, whether that was COVID shutting down our ninth grade year or being virtual our 10th, after today, you can say that you are a high school graduate. As we part ways and embark on different journeys in our lives, take every opportunity you get to dream and succeed. In the words of Atlanta rapper Lil Baby, live your life to the fullest, nothing is promised. This is the time that we have to go out and get what we want. There's not going to be anyone holding our hands along the way. We're going to make mistakes, but the only thing we can do is learn from them. Your success can only be achieved by you. Use any future obstacles as building blocks to create the best version of yourselves. Find the people who will always have your backs through thick and thin and hold on to them with everything you have. There is not a doubt in my mind that every one of you will leave a lasting impact on this world. It's been a crazy 4 years, class of 23, from the homecoming pep rally freshman year to Mrs. YBJ's Don't Try It on Tiger Trail earlier this year. I have enjoyed every moment laughing with you, 23. I wish you all success and prosperity in your lives. The class of 2023 has chosen All of the Lights as our class song. Most of us got reintroduced to this song during the Super Bowl halftime show this year. It opens with Rihanna singing, "Turn up the lights in here, baby. Extra bright, I want y'all to see this." By turning up the lights, Kanye and his celebrity pals want to enlighten us on how their lives really are. We have all seen how people put on the facades to fit in, but class of 23, I want to encourage y'all to stay true to yourselves. Don't let others belittle your achievements and change the person you are. As the sun goes down on our journey on one trail, remember all of the lights are on you. Now for the moment we've all been waiting on. In academic tradition, a non-matriculated student wears their tassel on their mortarboard on the right side. However, once the diploma is conferred, the student moves the tassel from to the left, joining a select company of educated individuals. In recognition of your new status, I invite all of my classmates to move their tassels to the left as we applaud their achievements. And one last time, class of 2023, congratulations!
As we conclude tonight's ceremony, please note that the faculty staff will recess out, followed by our graduates. Please also note that the guests are not permitted in the auditorium following the ceremony. You may meet your graduate in the space in the front of the auditorium. Congratulations again to graduates, and have a great night.
I'm good. I slept my girl, Chicago Pigs. I get that time, you can spend that bread. I'm headed home, I'm almost there. I'm on my way, yeah, you ever stay. To my surprise, I had to replace a meeting. I had to take a tea, they get a room, but I'm in the line. I need to shout, I need to pass, I need to ride, I need to go, I need to be a light. I'm on the line, I'm on the line, I need to pass, I need to go, I need to go, I need to find, I need to get everything. I'm on the line, I need to get a baby. I'm going to get a baby, please. I'm going to get a baby.